Hey, that's my rewards done for the day. The Dark Knight Rises is only 10p. I'll have that. Sweet, thanks Google Rewards.
It's a vlog.
And this is why I keep the curtains shut for when I'm doing my vlogs, even though that kind of flickers now and again. I'm referring to what happened on the last vlog because the camera kind of flickered. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen, welcome to Steety Films, it's a vlog. So, what videos I made this past 1 week? Even though I made a week worth of videos last week, I kind of made a few videos this past 1 week, some of which were very unexpected and I didn't realise that it was going to happen. One of which, and that is basically the 3DS themes came out, the 3DS theme update came out this past 1 week, which was very unexpected since considering that I actually mentioned about at the end of my last vlog, and mentioned about 3DS themes or whenever it's going to come out, because it was meant to come out in Japan first type thing this month, but we didn't have the referred date for the UK and plus the US and whatnot, and it came out this past 1 week, so I did a walkthrough about the new update and stuff like that. Speaking about themes, on the subject on themes, and now I'm going to go off topic on this, but it's referring to this, but basically, not only the 3DS will be getting, just got themes, but at an interview on the podcast, Phil Spencer, the head of Xbox, did mention that they are working on some themes and plus that gamer picks and screenshots for the Xbox One, which I'm really looking forward to because I'm fed up with the same black background and all that, even though that I'm used to it on my, you know, good old Windows phone, let alone I can customize stuff on my Windows 8. Anyways, back on the subject on videos. Not only the 3DS themes came out this past 1 week, the demo for Bayonetta 2 came out this past 1 week, which was unexpected because usually I check up on stuff what comes out eShop this past 1 week and the week onwards, but I didn't check up on it this week and I didn't realise that there was going to be a Bayonetta 2 demo. And as soon as I looked up on Twitter, thanks Twitter, there was a demo that was out, so I did some gameplay that which was quite nice, which was really good gameplay. Like I said at the end of the video, I would get that game, however, but there's loads of other games I want to get and all that, but it's still a good Wii U title for any Wii U owners, and plus that for Nintendo people that never actually played the first Bayonetta. Anyways, and finally I did an unboxing of the good old camouflage controller, because as you may know, on my Facebook and my Twitter feeds, I had a bit of problems getting this controller, and it's finally out, and I actually did an unboxing, which I'm really happy with this, getting this controller. I'm really loving it. Yeah. And finally, these are the videos that I could have made, but I had slight problems though. One of which, I was going to do some gameplay of the Minecraft Doctor Who Skin Pack Volume 1 that came out this past 1 week on Xbox One, even though it came out last week on Xbox 360. And I would have done some gameplay of it, but I haven't got much Microsoft credit. Even though that I got the Xbox One controller and I got extra monies afterwards, when I got traded it in and whatnot, if you haven't watched the video. But other than that though, it's a shame I couldn't do some gameplay of it. But however, speaking about Minecraft, Minecraft for the PlayStation Vita will be coming out next week, which I'm really looking forward to, and I would like to do some gameplay of it. And it'll be kind of my first ever gameplay on my PS Vita, which will be quite nifty. Whew! So there's the kind of videos that I did this past 1 week. Just want to mention some Xbox related things that happened this past 1 week and plus what I've been playing and whatnot. First of which, and that is the Project Spark game is now out of beta, which is quite nifty. In case you do not know what Project Spark is, it's a free to play game and Little Big Planet type game, which is for Xbox, which is quite nifty. A few months back, this past following year, it has been on beta for quite a while, and I have received the beta, and then it was open beta for everyone else, and now just this past 1 week, basically it's gone off beta, and plus re-released on Xbox Live and Xbox One, and plus that for PC users, in case you do have Windows 8, you can also play on Windows 8, just a hint for PC users. But other than that though, it's nice however that they re-released this on Xbox One, plus on Windows 8. I have played the beta for quite a while, and also know that I would have done some gameplay of it re-released on Xbox One, but I already did some gameplay of the beta, and there's not much of a slight change in difference, all because it's in different layouts, this, that, and the other, because as you may know, it was on beta, and it's just off beta, and just some things have changed, just the layouts and stuff, but nothing major, just the gameplay is still similar. And plus like that, for the achievement hunters out there, it has got some extra achievements. So in case you wanted to play a particular free game on your Xbox One, yeah, there's actually a good game for the Xbox One for anyone that's in budget on getting games for the Xbox One. And it's just a nice free game, even though it's already been on beta and open beta for many months, and there's just not much people have been playing it. But Star Wars is just a nice game, however, you can actually just like play Tetris and other types of old school classic games onto that, which is quite nifty. Speaking about achievements and plus Project Spark in general, not only have I been playing a bit of Project Spark when it was on Open Bay and got some extra achievements, and plus that I've been playing Forza Horizon 2 and Destiny and whatnot, I have recently got up to 71k gamer score, woohoo! I recently reached up to my next K, which is quite nifty. Even though it is slightly getting a bit better now since I've been getting loads of new games lately, and it's improved my achievement score, which is quite good. But other than that, though, yeah, it's just nice to reach up to my next K. I know I'm bragging a lot, even though I mention it loads and loads of time each time I go to my next K. But I'm really looking forward to, as I mentioned beforehand, looking forward to getting up to 75k for Xbox Live Awards to get some extra rewards when reaching up to 75k and whatnot. But other than that, though, I'm actually pleased with my gamer score out of all the games I've been playing lately. This past one week, the new event that's happened on Destiny this past one week, which is the Iron Banner event that's happened this past one week. I would have done the Queen event that happens on the last event, but I couldn't access it though, because you have to be a certain level and certain armors and all that to be able to access the event. And I heard on the internet also it was quite hard anyway, so I couldn't maybe able to do it anyways because I'm a bit of a noob on most things. But other than that though, at least the Iron Banner I can access anyways. And the Iron Banner event is quite time consuming, it is, because you need loads of reputation. Well, just loads of respect. And basically, you need loads of respect to be able to, access loads of the cool things that they got. And also not only that, they've been having problems with it, because basically level, 5 or something, basically they can beat, level 20 and stuff, but there's been issues like that. But it's just me, however, I just can't get loads of respect because my team keeps blooming losing all the time, because you need to be able to win a match to get loads of respect and stuff, let alone doing certain challenges. And most of the challenges are quite, not saying challenging, it's just requires you to have the armor shaders and plus the emblem to be able to access the challenges and stuff. It's just time consuming, it is. Let alone I'm quite happy playing in Crucible and just happy playing Crash. And I just really enjoyed that more. And just last night when I was playing, I actually got top score, which I'm actually pleased of and quite happy. But other than that though, it's just things like that. I'm just like, durr. But other than that though, that's Destiny in a nutshell for me. I enjoy Destiny as it is, even though that I hardly ever played the story. But I enjoyed the multiplayer side of things, and I just play it now and again, even though that most people don't play it, but they just play it anyways. Because it's like, yeah, I'm playing this. I don't know why I'm playing it, but I'm playing it anyways. Because, I watch this thing on YouTube, or Honest Trailers on Destiny. It's just quite funny. On the last vlog, I kind of mentioned there are not much videos to do this month, even though there are slight things that are popping up that I kind of did some videos of. But however, this past one week, they meant Some companies mentioned about a beta and plus an alpha on something, which is quite nice. And basically, this past 1 week, and the Fable Legends beta has been announced that they will be doing a beta next week. And if you have already signed up, you need to sign up. Even though I signed up since the announcement, I didn't know if it was at E3 or Gamescom when they announced the beta. But other than that, I kind of like signed up then, and then I got email saying, oh, you need to sign up again just to confirm you sign up and stuff. I'm like, fair enough. But however, we'll see how it goes next week if I'm allowed to do some video gameplays of it. But yeah, I'm looking forward to playing the Fable Legends beta. But other than that though, that's something to look forward to. Also that on the week of Halloween, basically the alpha for Evolve will be coming out at October 30th, which I'm looking forward to doing some gameplay of, I'm not big on Evolved, but it's just, like I said beforehand, it's nice how they delayed the game until February to beat the whole holiday rush, but it's nice how they're releasing an alpha this month, and plus they'll release a beta in January, get my Julys and Julys mixed up. But other than that though, I'm looking forward to playing the alpha, and plus it'll be my very first alpha as well. And plus I heard on the internet also, you're allowed to do some gameplay footage of that, and just hope I get access to it. I have signed up for it, thanks internet. But other than that though, we'll see how it goes, and I'll do some gameplay for that for you guys. So I'm looking forward to doing them two particular alpha and beta to do some gameplay of. So I'm looking forward to doing some gameplay of that and whatever videos that I make throughout this month. Just want to quickly mention, in case anyone is kind of interested, let alone it'll finish until tomorrow on Sunday, but basically on Xbox 360, not on Xbox One, but basically it's Gold Weekend on Xbox 360 on Xbox Live. Yay, in case anyone's interested. I usually like to promote these, even though I'm not sponsored or I just like to mention about Games for Gold, even though they don't usually do Games for Gold for Xbox One, mainly because they got the shared system, which you never heard on the Xbox One, in case someone has a Gold subscription on the Xbox One, and you have like friends over and stuff, you can actually access their subscription and basically use your account and basically go online, and you're just using their Gold subscription on the Xbox One, which most people not know about. Because my CEX friend, when he used to have a free membership or silver membership on Xbox Live, he usually takes advantage of my Gold subscription and basically goes online and plays whatever he feels like playing and whatnot, which is it's a great advantage for when I have friends over and stuff, and they could just play whatever and use my Gold subscription. But overall, over-topicking, but still, however, it's just nice that they're still doing Gold Weekends for Xbox 360 users, but it'll die out at some point, only Xbox 360, sorry to say. That's enough Xbox-related stuff for now, but I just want to mention something which I want to mention about, which is some boring, like, serious related stuff that is not game related, so feel free to click off this video if you want to, and yeah, but if you want to listen to this, do listen. But basically, just some things that I've just this past following year that I've been really struggling with, and it is getting a bit worse now. As you may not know me by now, I mentioned this many times in the past vlogs now, and just to get you guys understanding and plus all that, for not only for my old subscribers that know me quite well, but I need to refresh you guys on certain things, and plus all that, for those that are new and recently new and subscribing, I just want you to let you guys know as well that I can be really unsocial sometimes, let alone if you may look at my old videos and plus stuff in the past. I do like socializing a lot, and when I'm in college and have other friends, I have previous housemates living here and other types of variations like that, I do socialise now and again, but sometimes I can be a bit unsocial. And this past following year, I have been really unsocial lately, let alone replying to like YouTube comments that I stopped doing now. Not saying in bad respects, it's just that some of the comments can be stupid and can't be bothered to reply. And it's just not only that, it's just I just have unsocial problems and stuff like that, and it's just really starting to get really, really worse. And it's just hard to explain it, not only on camera as well, also like that, speaking about that, even though that I'm talking to you guys now, oh, Stephen, you talk like a pro and stuff, let alone your speech is a bit meh, but still have a, you're talking now and you're talking on the camera, but that's just a camera, and I'm used to that for many years on when being on YouTube, and it's just in when I go out in public and stuff, I can be really shy, and I have been really unsocial lately, and plus that, I have really bad, like, habits. Like, I'd rather let people talk to me first. And sometimes it can be a bit of a struggle. And plus, I had to force myself to be able to talk first. And it is really struggling for me. And also, it's just I've been really unsocial lately. And it is kind of really affecting me. And it is kind of getting a bit worse. Let alone the needs that I have. Speaking about my needs, it's just that not much people understand my needs and all that. Sure, I have loads and loads of problems, let alone it comes to my reading, my writing, and my spelling. No judging, you guys know what I mean by my Twitter and Facebook and whatnot, let alone and cats and caps and all that. But it's just how I type, and it's just because of my dyslexia, and I've been diagnosed with dyslexia in college and stuff like that, and other things though, and it's just other things as well, like I have really bad habits and other types of habits, OCD problems and other types of things, like my unsocial stuff, like for example, it's just getting worse, and other types of things, and it's just hard to explain now as well, because I've been thinking about this when I was sleeping, and then in the morning I completely forgot what I was going to say, because I was going to mention about my vlog today, but it's just a really touching thing. And plus like that, no one ever listens. No one ever listens. Even though you mentioned about years and years and years and stuff like that. Like, for example, you know, like, oh, Stephen, why do you have loads of video games and you don't hardly play them and stuff and all that? And topics like that do bring up now and again from old groups and sometimes little small groups now and again from now. And talk about this topic about me getting buying video games, but it just keeps me happy, it does, and all that. And also another thing is just basically loads of people like to complain about that, and let alone other types of topics and stuff, and just other things like that. It's just no one ever listens, even though you mention about these sort of things, and trying to convince people to understand the needs, the habits, and plus all the other things I have, but no one ever listens. And throughout the years and years of BS that I put through, from YouTube, and plus in public, in real life, when it comes to my family, friends, relationships, there's so much BS in this world, and it's just hard to take the facts straight. That no one ever listens. No one will ever listen to you. And sure, you just mention about these subjects now and then again, let alone, you know, the subjects that happened this past few weeks ago. I know I'm going off topic a bit. But the past few weeks, you know, the subject, the whole being a gamer type thing, and has been controversy a lot lately the past few weeks about subjecting to people that are gamers. And all that. I won't go into too much detail about it, but it's just things like that have happened this past week. But it's just on the subject on that alone, it's just not much people will respect you and accept you for who you are, and, you know, like, the needs that you have, and just won't respect you. Sure, I do have, like, you know, friends and family that still understand me, and also that is just that, let alone my mum in general, because my mum knows me quite well. And also that I'm still learning myself to understand how I tick, and plus how to resolve these problems myself, let alone my mum understands how I work and stuff. It's just that I'm still learning today what most things in the society do today, and let alone I managed to get my independence and live independently thanks to Lincoln's Community Trust. But still, however, I'm still learning today, and I'm still acting like a teenager, even though I'm a young adult now and 26 years old. But still, in society today, I'm still learning, and you know, I've been forced in training, I was trying to learn most things. It's just that, you know, with all the problems I have, it just would not accept. And it's just hard to explain these sort of things to people and just explain them over and over again and all that. And it's been really stressing me out with these sort of things. It's just hard to get people to respect and accept me for who I am and all that. I know this was a very touchy thing to say, but basically this past 1 week I've been trying to force myself to try and socialise a bit more because I replied to a few people on Twitter and whatnot and trying my very best to socialise a bit more because it has been very hard for me and stuff. And as you may know from the few vlogs now, and basically I have been really stressed with most things and other types of variations. But I've not been stressed too much. I've been stressed out now and again. It's just that, other than that, at least the things that do keep me happy, and that is, you know, making YouTube videos, playing video games, and it just keeps me happy and all that. Sure, I do buy loads of video games and don't play as much, but it just keeps me happy and I enjoy it, and I just like to share the experience on YouTube and stuff. But it's just, no one will ever listen. Even if you listen to that touchy subject, no one will listen. I learned that in the hard way. No one will listen. And people will start talking about it, and I just ignore them and basically just get on with my life and stuff like that. Because no one will listen. The people will just start saying the same subject over and over again until, you know, I just longer be no more. And then again, people will still talk about it. So, hey, do you remember that person, you know, that does this and that, you know? Do you see what I mean? And then again, no one ever listen. Anyways, so what I've been doing this past 1 week, even though I've been a bit, you know, stressed and playing video games and whatnot. I've been out a few times with my mum, just to, you know, because my mum understands what I've been going through, and she's been inviting me out to a few shops now and again. And we've been to, like, Tesco's and plus a store a few days after, which was quite nice. But in Tesco's, however, knowing me with my Tesco's and Tesco's Express, basically, I picked up some mince pies that were, like, 19p each, and I've been eating them this past 1 week. I've been eating a bit too much this past 1 week, but it was quite nice, though, to get them mince pies for 19p. Even though that I did say that I've been unsocial and whatnot, blah, 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 I did, however, because I haven't seen him for quite a while, he came to visit a nice, my CEX friend, which he came over, which was quite nice, and he brought his PS4 over, and he got Shadow of Mordor that he got from CEX from where he works, which was quite nice, and I've been watching him play it, even though I know loads of people have been playing it. But it's not my sort of game, however, like Alien Isolation and plus, you know, Shadow of Mordor, because those have been coming out this past following month. But I've got some other games that I've been playing, you know, like Forza Horizon 2 and Destiny and whatnot. So I've been just been playing them, let alone playing Shadow of Mordor and Alien Isolation. But it's just that these are not my sort of types of games I would play, even though it's funny because my CEX friend's like, oh, you never play a good game, you only play the really stupid ones like Forza Horizon 2, which has been out for many, which has been doing multiple times, let alone Halo, because my CEX friend doesn't particularly like Halo, even though he's been playing Destiny lots on PlayStation 4. Even I mentioned the last a few vlogs ago that I was a bit hypocritical about Destiny. He's been playing Destiny a lot since when you played the beta, mine. Anyways, what videos I'll be doing next week? I thought of a film sketch video to do, even though I haven't made a film sketch video for quite a while. But I have thought of one to maybe do. I didn't know to do it next week or the week after, even though that it'll be my anniversary, my 8-year anniversary on YouTube soon, and I had to make a particular video, even though I'm not very good when it comes to doing my anniversary videos. I need to do that next week after when I do my next vlog next week and whatnot. But like I said beforehand, the Minecraft for PlayStation V will be coming next week, and I'll do some gameplay of that. And plus now that the Fable Legends and Bayer, that is if I'm allowed to do some gameplay of that, we'll have to see. But a few videos next week, we'll have to see on the outcome next week, even though I made a few videos this week. which I did, and which I'm great to do, even though I made a week worth the week after. But at least you got some content to be able to watch in case you haven't already watched it. So anyways, that's a bit of a vlog for you guys. Hope you've been updated. Sorry that was kind of a really lengthy vlog again, and sorry that I had to mention about these touchy subjects, but like I said beforehand, I don't think people listen. I know most people do care, but it's just some things I've been going on a bit lately, and it's just stressing me out and all that, and it's just many things that happened this past following year and all that. But other than that though, yeah, what can you do? That's life. Anyways, so yeah, do not forget to follow me on Facebook and Twitter, and hope you guys have a nice rest of your weekend. Yeah, because I made a vlog on Saturday, because, you know, the controller came out, you know, yesterday and whatnot. So yeah, don't forget to check out all my other videos. Anyways, I'll just leave you in peace now, and I'll show up now. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.